Hello everyone. Welcome to our tutorial on utilizing Blazor JavaScript interoperability for rendering SSRS RDL reports in Bold Reports Viewer. Let's say you are developing a Blazor application and need to integrate a reporting feature to display reports within it. Specifically, you want to add the report viewer control provided by Bold Reports. This video will show the steps to utilizing Blazor JavaScript interoperability for rendering SSRS RDL reports in Bold Reports Viewer to display an already created report. You will need to set two API properties to render RDL reports in the Blazor application. They are: the reporting service URL API is used to interact with server-side report processing, and the report path API sets the path of the report to be rendered. I have already installed the .NET SDK on my machine to create a Blazor application with Visual Studio Code. Let's start by creating a Blazor application through the command prompt. First, I create an application named Blazor Bold Report Viewer. Once the application is created, I need to install the NuGet packages to add the necessary dependencies to the application. To do this, I change the current working directory to the application's root folder. I then add the boldreports.net.core package to the application. This NuGet package contains all the dependency packages to add the Bold Reports report viewer to the application. Next, I create a resources folder in the www root folder of my application to store the RDL reports. For this video, I'm going to use the salesorderdetails.rdl file already available to me, which I add to the resources folder. You will find the download link for the salesorderdetails.rdl file in this video's description. After adding the sample report to the application, let me initialize the report viewer in the project. In this section, I will integrate JavaScript controls by creating an interop file to initialize the report viewer with basic parameters. First, I need to set the report service URL and report path API properties to render the reports from the specified path. So, I create a new class file named boldreportviewer_options.cs within the data folder. Then, I declare the Blazor boldreportviewer.data namespace and define the boldreportviewer_options class within it. This class contains the report path and the report service URL properties for configuring the report viewer component into a Blazor application. Next, I create a scripts folder within the www root directory to hold the script files. Then, I create a JavaScript file named boldreports.interop.js within the scripts folders. I add the render viewer function to invoke the Bold Report Viewer JavaScript control in the Blazor project. The report path specifies the path to the report that you want to render, and report service URL specifies the URL of the report service that processes and renders the report. Now, I need to reference the scripts and the style sheet. Here, I am using CDN links to reference the report viewer scripts and style sheet. You can also use local scripts and themes. I have included an FAQ link about using them in the video description. Next, I open the layout.cshtml file in the pages folder. Then, I copy the code from the documentation and add the CDN links with the boldreports.interop.js interop file to use the JavaScript reporting controls in the head tag. Now, I will configure the web API. The Blazor app requires a web API service to render the report viewer control. So, I create a new controller file named reportviewercontroller.cs within the data folder. In that file, I need to add all the necessary using statements as references and then declare namespaces and add classes. So, I add the Microsoft.ASP.NET Core.MVC namespace to the controller file, which lets me build the web application, including web APIs, and provides routing and model binding. And I add the boldreports.web.reportviewer namespace, which provides the class and interfaces specific to the Bold Reports library and is used to configure and manage the report viewer. Next, I add the Microsoft.ASP.NET Core.HTTP namespace, which is used to handle HTTP requests and responses. Additionally, I add the Microsoft.Extensions.Caching.Memory namespace, which provides in-memory caching capabilities to store and retrieve data quickly. Finally, I add the System.IO namespace, which works with input-output operations, such as reading from and writing to data streams and files. Then, I add the Blazor Bold Report Viewer.Data namespace to avoid naming conflicts. Inside that, I add the root attribute to the Report Viewer Controller class. Next, I inherit the controller base and implement the iReport controller interface in the Report Viewer Controller class to handle the viewing of reports. The iReport controller interface has a declaration of action methods required in the Web API controller for processing reports and handling resource requests. To read the report file from the application, I use the iWeb hosting environment with dependency injection. Next, I add the getResource method to get images to be used in the report from the server when I preview the report in the designer. The action name, getResource, and accept verbs, get attributes specify the endpoint and HTTP verb for retrieving resources. Then I add the onInitReportOptions method, which is invoked from a report helper when the report is about to be processed at the time of preview. Inside the method, I need to load the report as a stream. So, I create a base path variable to combine the web root path of the application and the resources folder. Then, I create a report path variable to combine the base path and report name using reportOption.reportModel.reportPath to access the available report. Next, I create a file stream instance to open the salesorderdetails.rdl report file located in the resources folder within the www root directory using the report path variable. Then, I create a memory stream to hold the report data in memory. And copy the file stream to a memory stream. This copy process will help avoid file access problems in the server while running the application on it. Finally, I assign the report stream values to the report option.reportModel.stream variable. Next, I add the onReportLoaded method, which will be invoked from a report helper when the report and subreport start loading for report rendering. I then add the postform report action to save the exported report to the client side using the HTTP post action. Finally, I add the postReport action method to process the report request from the server side based on a JSON parameter and send the response back to the client side using the HTTP post action. Now I need to invoke the web API in the controller from the client side to view the report. So, I open the index.razor file in the pages folder. And add the Microsoft.js Interop and Microsoft.ASP.NET Core.Components namespaces and inject the IJS runtime. These are used to invoke the JavaScript function from the Blazor component. Additionally, I add the Blazor Bold Report Viewer.Data namespace, in which Blazor Bold Report Viewer is the name of the application. Next, I create a div element to contain the rendered report on the client side. And assign the ID attributes and styles to it. The ID attribute specifies the unique name for the HTML element, so I assign the value report viewer. The style attribute is used to add the inline style for the div element, and I assign width and height. Inside the code, I create an instance of the Bold Report Viewer Options class. And initialize the render report viewer method. Inside the method, I assign values to the report path and report service URL properties. Then, I add the invoke void async method, which invokes the renderViewer JavaScript function asynchronously. Next, I add the onAfterRender within the code, which is called after the reportViewer component has been rendered. Next, I open the program.cs file and invoke the app.mapController's function to enable routing to controller action methods, allowing incoming HTTP requests to be mapped to the appropriate actions based on attributes. Finally, I need to register the license token to remove the license validation message. In this demo, I am going to use the online license token. License tokens can be generated in the Claim License Key section of the Bold Reports Accounts page. I enter the code snippet to register the token. I have provided a link to documentation on registering a license using online license tokens and offline license keys in this video's description. Now, everything is ready to preview the report. So, I run this command in the command prompt and then build the application. Then, I copy the URL and run it in a browser. See, the sales order details report is rendered in the Blazor application. In this video, I have shown you how to utilize Blazor's JavaScript interoperability for rendering SSRS RDL reports in Bold Reports Viewer. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.